Biology, Chapter 7, Structural Organization in Animals, of Class 11. Topics to be discussed in this chapter are animal tissues and morphology and anatomy of cockroach. Organs and organ systems. A group of similar cells along with intercellular substances performing a special function is called a tissue. Complex animals consist of four basic types of tissues. The tissues are organized to form organs. Two or more organs that interact to perform a common function constitute organ systems. Cells, tissues, organs and organ system exhibit division of labor and contribute to the survival of the body as a whole. Each organ is made up of one or more type of tissues. Example, heart consists of epithelial, connective, muscular and neural tissues. Animal tissues. A tissue is a group of similar cells having a specific functions and origin. Animal tissue are broadly classified into four types: epithelial tissue, connective tissue, muscular tissue and neural tissues. Epithelial tissues or epithelium. These tissue provide a covering or a lining of some part of body. Therefore, it has a free surface which faces either a body fluid or the outside environment. The cells of epithelial tissues are compactly packed with little intercellular matrix. The epithelial tissue rests on a new non-cellular basement membrane and receives nutrients from the underlying connective tissues. Classification of epithelial tissue. Epithelial tissue are broadly classified as follows. It has been classified into main part, simple epithelium and compound epithelium. Simple epithelium is single layered and compound epithelium is multi-layered. Simple epithelium. Simple epithelium is composed of a single layer of cells and function as a lining for body cavities, ducts and tubes. It has been classified in three types: squamous epithelium, cuboidal epithelium, and columnar epithelium. Squamous epithelium. Squamous epithelium is made up of single thin layer of flattened cells with irregular boundaries. It forms inner lining of alveoli or air sac of lungs, blood vessels, endothelium. It is involved in the formation of diffusion boundaries. Animal tissues. A tissue is a group of similar cells having a specific functions and origin. Animal tissue are broadly classified into four types: epithelial tissue, connective tissue, muscular tissue, and neural tissues. Columnar epithelium. It is composed of single layer of tall and slender cells having nuclei at their base. It is found in the lining of stomach and intestine. The free surface of the cells may have microvilli, then it is called brush border columnar epithelium. It is involved in the functions of secretion and absorption. Modification of columnar or cuboidal cells. Ciliated epithelium. When columnar or cuboidal cells bear cilia on their free surface, the epithelium is called ciliated epithelium. It is mainly present in the inner surface of hollow organs like bronchioles and fallopian tubes. The cilia of the epithelium help to move particles or mucus in the specific direction over the epithelium. Simple epithelium. Simple epithelium is composed of a single layer of cells and function as a lining for body cavities, ducts and tubes. It has been classified in three types: squamous epithelium, cuboidal epithelium and columnar epithelium. squamous epithelium. Squamous epithelium is made up of single thin layer of flattened cells with irregular boundaries. It forms inner lining of alveoli or at sac of lungs, blood vessels, endothelium. It is involved in the formation of diffusion boundaries. Compound epithelium. It is made up of more than one layer, multi-layered of cells. Compound epithelium covers the dry surface of skin and moist surface of buccal cavity, pharynx, inner lining of ducts of salivary gland and of pancreatic. The main function of compound epithelium is to provide protection against chemical and mechanical stress. Cell junction. Cell junctions are specialized structures which provide both structural and functional links between the cells of animal tissue. Following three of types of junctions are found in the epithelium and other tissues. 1. Tight junction. Plasma membrane of adjacent cells are fused at interval and help to stop substance from leaking across the tissue. 2. Adhering junction. Perform cementing function to keep neighboring cells together. Gap junction. Facilitate the cells to communicate with each other by connecting the cytoplasm of adjoining cells for rapid transfer of ions, small molecules and sometimes big molecules. The tissue specialized junction provide both structural and functional links between its individual cells. Simple epithelium. Simple epithelium is composed of a single layer of cells and function as a lining for body cavities, ducts and tubes. It has been classified in three types: squamous epithelium, cuboidal epithelium and columnar epithelium. Squamous epithelium. Squamous epithelium is made up of single thin layer of flattened cells with irregular boundaries. It forms inner lining of alveoli or at sac of lungs, blood vessels, endothelium. It is involved in the formation of diffusion boundaries. Loose connective tissue. Loose connective tissue has cells and fibers loosely arranged in semi-fluid ground substance or matrix. It is of two types, areolar tissue and adipose tissue. Areolar tissue. It is present beneath the skin and serves as a support framework for epithelium. It contains three types of cells, fibroblasts, cells that produce and secrete fibers, macrophages and mast cells. Cell junction. Cell junctions are specialized structures which provide both structural and functional links between the cells of animal tissue. Following three of types of junctions are found in the epithelium and other tissues. 1. The tissue specialized junction provide both structural and functional links between its individual cells. Dense regular tissue. The collagen fibers are present in rows between many parallel bundles of fibers. Example, tendons and ligaments. Tendons attach skeletal muscles to bones. Ligaments attach one bone to another. Loose connective tissue. Loose connective tissue has cells and fibers loosely arranged in semi-fluid ground substance or matrix. It is cell junction. Cell junction are specialized structure which provide both structural and functional links between the cells of animal tissue. Following three of types of junction. The tissue specialized junction provide both structural and functional links between its individual cells. Simple epithelium. Simple epithelium is composed of a single layer of cells and function as a lining for body cavities, ducts and tubes. It has been classified in bones. The bones have hard and non-pliable ground substance or matrix. It is rich in calcium salts and collagen fibers, which provide strength to the bones. The osteocytes are bone cells present in the space called lacunae in the matrix. Bones provide structural frame to the body and protect softer tissues and organs. Dense regular tissue. The collagen fibers are present in rows between many parallel bundles of fibers. Example, tendons and ligaments. Tendons attach skeletal muscles to bones. Cell junction. Cell junction are specialized structure which provide both structural and functional links between the cells of animal tissue. Following three of types of junctions are found in the epithelium and other tissues. 1. Tight junction. Plasma membrane of adjacent cells are fused at interval and help to stop substance from leaking across. Muscular tissue. Muscular tissue is composed of many long cylindrical, highly contractile muscle cells or fibers. Each fiber is made up of numerous fine fibrils called myofibrils. On stimulation, muscle fibers contract or shorten and then relax or lengthen to return to their uncontracted state in a coordinated manner. Muscles bring about locomotion and movement of various organs. Simple epithelium. Simple epithelium is composed of a single layer of cells and function as a lining for body cavities, ducts and tubes. It has been classified in three types: squamous epithelium, cuboidal epithelium and columnar epithelium. Skeletal muscles. Skeletal muscles are closely attached to skeleton bones and consist of long cylindrical multinucleated fiber. They have a streak appearance, hence are called striated muscles. The skeletal muscle fibers are bundled together in a parallel fashion and several bundles are covered in the sheet of connective tissue. Example, biceps in upper arms. The activity of skeletal muscles are under voluntary control, hence called voluntary muscles. A sheet of taut connective tissue includes several bundles of muscle fibers. Smooth muscles. Smooth muscles consist of spindle-shaped unnucleated fibers. The fibers do not show striations. The cell junctions hold them together and they are bundled together in a connective tissue sheet. Some smooth muscles are present in the walls of internal organs such as stomach, intestine, blood vessels, etc. The activity of smooth muscles are not under voluntary control, hence are called involuntary muscles. Cardiac muscles. Cardiac muscles are made up of short cylindrical uninucleated fibers and are present only in the heart wall. The cell junction fuses the plasma membrane of several muscle cells to form a branching pattern. Intercalated disc or communication junctions are present at some fusion points, which allow the muscle cells to contract as a unit. The cardiac muscles are faintly striated and are involuntary in nature. Neural tissue. Neural tissue control body's function and responsiveness to changing conditions. Neurons are the functional unit of neural tissue and are excitable cells. Neural glia cells make up more than half the volume of neural tissue. They protect and support neurons. When a neuron is stimulated, an electrical disturbance or impulse is generated and travels along its plasma membrane. There are different types of nerve fibers with nerve cells. Cell junction. Cell junction are